This is an Elf on the Shelf, and this is a Catalonian poop log. Two very strange Christmas traditions from opposite sides of the world. This is what happened when we tried to combine these traditions. Let me explain. So, the Elf on the Shelf. You've all seen these things before. They're those creepy dolls that move around your house and watch your behavior to report back to Santa. Well, at least today many think they're creepy, but it didn't always used to be that way. The Elf on the Shelf tradition began way back in the 1970s. Carol Abersole, the Georgia stay-at-home mother of three, pulled an old childhood Christmas ornament out of a box. A little stuffed elf named Fizbee. Every night, Fizbee would move to a different spot in the house, and the kids, two twin girls and their brother, would tell him everything they wanted for Christmas and do good deeds in front of him in hopes that he would send a glowing report back to Santa. Fast forward to 2004, where one of the twins, the now married Shonda Bell's family, was really struggling financially. She had to get a part-time job at her dad's business, bringing her new son along just to make ends meet. After work those days, Shonda would stop by her old childhood home to visit with her parents. Carol, her mother, was also in a really tough spot at that time. She was dealing with pretty significant health issues on top of already suffering greatly from empty nest syndrome. One December evening, the two were just sitting there, feeling sorry for themselves, when Shonda looked up and saw Fizbee sitting on the mantle. She and her mom decided to write a book sharing their beloved Elf on the Shelf tradition with the world, and ever since, it has exploded in popularity. I would like to make clear the fact that we were not aware of this touching cross-generational origins of the Elf on the Shelf before, so I do feel a little bit bad about what we did to this one. However, I feel that there are two reasons that make what we did justifiable. What started out as a heartwarming little tradition turned really creepy really fast. With the growth of the internet, people were able to share their Elf on the Shelf pictures with the world, and everyone started to try topping what they've seen. This led to a barrage of really creative, really elaborate, and sometimes really creepy pictures out there, and the general consensus from what I've heard today is that everyone who didn't grow up with the tradition finds it either pointless or creepy. The argument could be made that the creepiness has just become amalgamous with the tradition at this point, and what we did was just our creative extension of that. The other reason I'm fine with what we did is that our elf wasn't actually an elf on the shelf. His name was not Fizbee, it was Joe, the self-proclaimed head elf-fluencer. As part of a movement to update the tradition to the generation of YouTube and the internet, the Elf on the Shelf company came up with a brand new product, Joe. He was a special elf on the shelf who had his own talk show in the form of 5-minute YouTube episodes complete with special guest stars and really cheesy humor. I want you to listen to this clip and tell me that that is not the most annoying voice in the world.
Welcome to Coco with Joe.
It still gives me nightmares. Anyways, the toy version of Joe we were prank gifted with included a voice box inside. So we had the abomination that is this. At our fingertips at the push of a button. I may have spammed that one too many times to bother the person who gave it to us, and he may have proceeded to beat the doll with a metal rod and shatter its voice box. We actually performed surgery on old Joe, cutting his back open to see if the voice box was repairable. It was not, and we figured it was already destroyed, so why not go one step further? And that is where Cagatillo comes in, the Catalonian poop log. Before I talk about Cagatillo's origin, I should probably explain what the tradition is and why on earth it's called a poop log. Well, the basic premise is that this little log with legs and a face appears in Catalonian homes on December 8th, and for the rest of the month, the family would take care of it. They would give it a little blanket to keep it warm, feed it, and clean up after it, of all things. You would lift the blanket each morning to find that Cagatillo had pooped during the night. These droppings would include little candies, nougats, or raisins. So kids would literally eat this log's feces. But don't worry, it gets weirder. On Christmas Eve, everyone beats Cagatillo with a stick, chanting fun songs at him, and then they throw him in the fireplace and burn him for warmth. Yeah, the Elf on the Shelf tradition doesn't seem so weird anymore, does it? The Cagatillo tradition predates the Elf on the Shelf and even Christmas itself. It's probably a surprise to no one that this actually started as a Catalonian cult practice. It was a way for cultists to communicate with their ancestors or something, I don't know. The smoke from the burning log would be how they would call upon their ancestors, and the dung it would leave behind would be the response. Strangest telephone ever. When Christianity made its way to Catalonia sometime between 100 and 300 AD, the cult went away, but this strange tradition of theirs did not. All of the communicating with the dead stuff was removed, but for the most part, the Kagatiyo tradition has been unchanged for millennia, which should explain just why it's so bizarre. When we received our very own Kagatiyo in a white elephant gift exchange, we were very, very confused. There was a little letter included on what to do with it, laying out the whole pooping, beating, and burning routine. Not really sure what to do with it, we took it home and placed it under our Christmas tree, where it lay until a few weeks later when we had commenced our murderous rage against this thing. We started off simple, turning Joe into a piñata. Then we performed minor surgery on him, and he got to play his very first game of ping pong. After more surgery, Joe got to try baseball, and with the air full of the magical snow that was his innards, we had the brilliant idea to combine two international Christmas traditions. And by that, I mean combining the creepiness of Joe with the beating and burning of Kagatiyo. We quickly brought the smiling log into the mix, performing even more surgery to physically combine the two. I think we nailed it. Finally, the time came that we were all waiting for. We each gave our new monstrosity, dubbed Kaga Joe, one good whack with a bat, reminiscing on all the good times we had with his counterparts. Then, we lit the torch that we had constructed out of the remains of Joe's torso and watched the spectacle of the two going up in flames. Really quite something, isn't it? In our spur of the moment juxtaposition of these two Christmas traditions with very different origins, we accidentally created a brand new tradition that multiplied their strangeness tenfold. It's probably not something we're gonna do every year, but hey, if you're ever with some friends and you have a log and a stuffed elf, give it a try. It's a ton of fun. With that, I really hope you enjoyed this history lesson slash horror reel. It was definitely a weird one. If you did, make sure to beat that subscribe log with a stick and toss it into the fire if you want to catch more of our crazy antics in the future. Also, comment below with any weird holiday traditions from where you're from. I'll pin the weirdest one if it's actually true. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you all have a happy new year.